In this video, I am going to give you 5 tips to push past your fear of getting on camera. This is going to help you blow up your business online. Hey friends, and welcome back to Sparkle and Grow. Jamie here. We all know how important video is for your business these days. Online presence, social media, video is the way to get noticed today. Every business owner knows it, but so many people are afraid of it. I was so scared to get on camera when I first started doing this business. I was always really interested in sharing products online. I love network marketing. I love just the concept of the business, but I knew that everybody was getting on camera now, and that is why businesses were blowing up. And so I knew I needed to do it too, because otherwise, how are people going to put a personality to the business that I'm running? There are so many businesses out there, and if they don't feel connected to you as a person, it's just another product out there. Getting your face on camera is what is going to help people connect to you in a stronger way. There's no way around it. And really, this one I won't include in the tips because everybody hates this advice, but my biggest advice for you, if you are scared to get on camera, is to rip the band-aid off and get on camera. You have to face the fear head on. You have to do it. You have to do it afraid. The more you do it, the better you'll get at it and the less there will be fear. But if you don't do it and you don't just get out there, you're never gonna face it and it's never gonna get less. It lessens a little bit each time you do it. When I first started getting on camera, I was so scared. I would like turn red and I would sweat, and it was just like, you cannot tell all that stuff on camera. Maybe a little bit on the redness, but you know, nothing a little foundation can't fix. But if you're having a really hard time just like grasping the concept of getting on scared and doing it anyways and just ripping off the band-aid and going for it, I understand. It took me a lot of years to finally rip that band-aid off. So I'm gonna give you 5 tips that definitely helped me become more successful at getting on camera so that you can maybe baby step your way to ripping that band-aid off. Tip number 1 is knowledge. Knowledge equals confidence. Go ahead and plan what you're gonna say ahead of time. Don't just show up with a topic. Outline it. Don't fully write scripts. It's okay to write down some key sentences and sentence starters, but try to just create an outline for yourself to kind of glance at so you know where to go when your brain kind of freezes. And you can totally dive deep into the topic of what you're teaching ahead of time so that you know the knowledge for sure. And then the reminders in your outline are what's gonna kind of trigger your brain when you feel stuck and you can't remember it because you got that like stage fright going on. So simply getting more solid on the information you are going to share is gonna make you feel a lot more confident just in having that knowledge, because knowledge so often will translate to that confidence. Tip number 2 is just pretend you're talking to a friend. Put a picture of your best friend on your camera if you need to, and just chat about it. Pretend you're sharing what you just learned to her so that it feels more natural, so that you have your personality, so that it feels good to be excited when you tell the camera things. So many times people get on and they feel like they're being over the top, but when you sit down with your friend and you get excited, you're gonna say it with a more up voice, even to your friend. So make it natural and get excited and talk to your friend as if you have the most amazing thing to tell her. Another thing that kind of goes along with that is just like being real. It helps you be a little bit more real when you feel like you're just talking to a friend. Tip number 3, do clean yourself up. You do not have to be glamorous, you don't have to be over the top, you don't have to have a full face of makeup or anything crazy, but your confidence will increase if you feel more put together. You don't have to clean your space totally, but find maybe a blank wall so that they're not seeing your clutter behind you. Make sure you like how you look in the shirt that you're wearing. Make sure you brush through your hair that day. Make sure you you know, pick up your desk so it's not as messy as mine. But just cleaning up and making yourself feel a little bit more put together, even if it just means like a little bit of concealer and mascara, brush through your hair, favorite shirt, clean background, you will feel so much better with just that alone. Also, just having some aesthetics with your camera, making sure that you have some nice window lighting or a ring light, something bright, will really lift the energy of the video. So aesthetics are really important. You don't have to be a certain way or by any means perfect, but you should be a little bit more put together, and that's gonna lift your confidence a lot. Tip number 4 is gonna be practice in a private group. You can make a Facebook group with only yourself in it and go practice in that group. You can also use something on Instagram now that they just recently launched called Practice Mode. You'll notice that if you go do a live video, there is an option to do practice mode where you will literally practice going live. There's not going to be any audience, but it'll be the same experience for you to create and go through the steps. And you can still decide at the end if you're going to post it. So maybe by doing a practice like that, there's this chance you might still hit post, even though nobody necessarily watched it live for real, but it was a good practice run. You can totally do live or pre-recorded videos anyways. I do a combination of both. I actually probably pre-record a little more than live, but I try to go live at least maybe once a week. Another idea on that note, and it kind of relates to my second tip, is just FaceTime a friend and do it with your friend. So that might be your first audience member. Just call them on FaceTime so that you see their face and they see your face. Or if their face is too much, you know, like just let them see you and put a little piece of paper over it. But practicing in front of a friend will definitely give you a little bit more courage. And then you do have a friend that actually knows you're struggling with that fear and trying to get brave. And they're gonna push you a little bit to help you get on camera as well. And they might even show up to be in your live to give you that support. If you have friends that you know will show up and support you and that helps you, tell your friends when you're gonna go live and let them jump on. If you do network marketing like I do, you can also go to your team and ask your team to jump on right before you go live. Say, hey, I'm scared. Will you jump on and support me and cheer me on and help me out while I do this live video? And absolutely, your team is most likely going to say yes. And then number 5, my very last tip, is create an alter ego. Create a character of yourself. You shouldn't be anybody but yourself, but write down your best self and how you want to portray yourself on camera and maybe name it, you know, so that every time you get on camera, you're kind of slipping into character instead of basing your presence on camera on your current mood, because our moods fluctuate, and if we always base our camera presence on our current mood, you don't know when you're gonna show up. But you can gain that confidence and be more consistent if you know exactly who you are when you show up and how you show up and why your audience needs that person to show up. Create a character, create the character's purpose, and slip into character so that when you get on camera, you're gonna be that consistent personality that you want to show up for. It's totally not fake. Even Beyonce does it. Go Google Sasha Fierce. It's part of showing up on camera and portraying the person that you want to portray to best represent your brand and your products. So those are my 5 tips to help you feel a little bit more brave on camera. If you have any tips, please leave them in the comments. They might help somebody else. I appreciate you so much. If this was helpful for you, will you please give this video a thumbs up or a heart, depending on what platform you are watching it at? And then, of course, don't forget to follow and subscribe. I love you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Ta-ta!